Hollywood, where audiences have just seen the silent screen's latest smash, Monumental Pictures' The Royal Rascal. And here they are now, the stars of the picture, Lina Lamont and Don Lockwood. Lina and Don, what would you like to say to your adoring fans?
Well, we're pretty darn thrilled in response to The Royal Rascal. We had fun making it, and I really hope you have fun seeing it tonight, too.
And look, here comes Don's old vaudeville pal, Cosmo Brown. Don, did you ever imagine this? Here you are standing between the two people who have helped you become the success you are today. Your leading lady and your longtime writing partner. Take us back to where it all began.
No, Dora. Tonight is really about The Royal Rascal.
But Don, the story of your success is an inspiration to the young people all over the world. Just one little story, or maybe a song from your old act?
Fiddle the fiddle and ready for love. I can jump over the moon above.
Fiddle the fiddle and ready for love.
Having to worry, having to care. Feel like a feather that's floating on air. Fiddle the fiddle and ready for love.
Soon the church bells will be ringing and march with my pa. How the church bells will be ringing with a hey, na 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 na, ha cha cha. Hey, dear dear, my baby's okay. Ask me a riddle and what did she say? Fiddle the fiddle and ready for love. Church bells will be ringing, and watch with my and pa. How the church bells will be ringing, with the hey na 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 ha cha cha. Hey diddle dee, my baby's okay, and ask me a riddle, and what she say?
There's a fiddle and ready for love.
For a girl.
For heaven's sake! What's the idea? Singing a song in my opening? And can't a girl get an award at twice? They're my public, too!
Lena, the publicity department decided it'd be better if Don made all the speeches for the team.
Why?
Let's just say with a voice like yours, it's a good thing the movies are silent.
What's wrong with my voice?
Lena, you're a beautiful woman, and the audience thinks you've got a voice to match.
Like, dumb or something?
No, it's just that Don has so much more experience.
Next time, write me a speech. I can memorize it.
Oh, yeah. Why don't you go out there right now and recite the Gettysburg Address?
What do I care what Gettysburg lives? Donnie, how can you let him talk to me like that? Me, your fiancé.
Lena, you've been reading a lot of the fan magazines again. You shouldn't believe all the banana oil the columnists shout. There hasn't been anything between us, and there never has been anything between us, just air.
Oh, you don't mean that. Come on, darling, or we'll be late to Mr. Simpson's party.
Miss Lamont, we're going in separate cars, to break up the mobs.
Oh, Donnie, see you there.
Ta-ta, Lena, see you there.
Hurry up, Don. Hurry up, Don. We got a lot of press waiting.
Cooked up romance, Cosmo. Just for publicity.
Price of fame, Don. You got the glory. You got to deal with the heartaches that come with it. Let's get out of here.
You know what? I think I'd rather walk.
Are you kidding? The fans will mob you.
Do me a favor. You see that nice cashmere coat and hat? Put them on and step into my limo, and now you're Don Lockwood.
Sure, why not?
Thanks, guys. You get the party.
You look familiar.
Aren't you Don Lockwood?
Funny you should say that. I'm often mistaken for him. Actually, I'm just your average everyday citizen waiting for a trolley, here with my girl.
Hey, what are you doing?
Nothing.
I'm gonna call the police.
Don't worry, I'm not a criminal.
I don't care who you are, just go away!
Now look, let me explain.
You are a criminal! I've seen that face someplace! You're a famous gangster! I've seen your pictures in the papers or in the post office with a lot of numbers on your chest! Officer! Officer!
Yes, ma'am, anything wrong?
This man, he...
Oh, why, it's Don Lockwood.
Don Lockwood?
Out for a stroll?
Actually, yes.
Well, you sure are a lucky lady. Good night, Mr. Lockwood.
Good night, and mum's the word. Well, thanks for saving my life. I'd very much like to know whose hospitality I'm enjoying.
Selden. Kathy Selden.
Enchanted, Miss Selden. I'm sorry I frightened you. I was just getting a little too much love from my adoring fans.
I knew I'd seen you.
Of course. Which one of my pictures have you seen, though?
I don't remember. I saw one once. If you've seen one, you've seen them all.
Well, thank you.
Oh, no offense, but the personalities on the screen don't impress me. I mean, they don't even speak. They just make a lot of dumb faces. Well, you know.
You mean, like, what I do?
Well, yes.
Well, what's your loafy ambition in life that lets you sneer at my humble profession?
Well, I'm an actress.
What?
On the stage.
Oh, I'd like to see you act.
Well, I'm not in a play right now, but I will be. I'm going to New York, and...
New York? Oh, and we'll hear from you some day, won't we? As Kathy Selden, as Juliet, or as Lady Macbeth, or as King Lear. You have to wear a beard for that one, of course.
Oh, you can laugh if you want to, but at least the stage is an honorable, dignified profession. You're not a shadow on film. You're no flesh and blood.
Aren't you Don Lockwood? Look, it's Don Lockwood.
Oh, come on, kids, give me a break. Farewell, Ethel Bettymore. Come on, give me a break.
Mr. Brown, could you really get me into the movies?
I should think so.
Really?
There are ways.
What would I have to do?
Well, it's simple. Meet me at Lowe's Theater at 5 and tomorrow evening.
What, Cosmo?
I'll get you in. And I will, get you in and... wait, unless there's something playing that I've seen already, in which case you're on your own.
Oh, and so's your Aunt Tilly!
Thanks, everyone. Hi, Cosmo.
Hey, Don, I thought you weren't coming.
Listen, Cosmo, am I a good actor?
As long as I work for the Monumental, you're the greatest of them all.
No kidding, Cosmo. You're my pal, okay? You can tell me.
Are you kidding? Of course you're good. What's wrong with you?
Just keep telling me from time to time. You know, I feel a little, shaken.
Don!
Hello, Riff.
There you are, Donnie. Where you been? I was lonely.
Hello, Lina.
Listen, there's a man been coming into my office for a few months, and he claims he can make talking pictures.
Why would he want a picture to talk?
Well, the Warner Brothers are making a whole talking picture. They're calling it the Jazz Singer.
That'll never amount to a thing.
That's what they said about the horseless carriage.
Here you go, Arya.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here to honor our brightest stars in the Monumental Picture stable, Don Lockwood and Lina Lamont. It's for you too, a very special cake full of delicious surprises.
I enjoyed your performance tonight.
Excuse me.
Don't go. Now that I know that you live in a cake, let me see you home.
Who is this dame anyway?
An actress on the legitimate stage. She couldn't learn anything from the movies.
Here's one thing I learned from the movies. Gee, I'm sorry. I didn't mean...
Oh, Lena. I'm so sorry.
Let me at her! I'll kill her!
It was just a mistake, Lena. A little accident.
Sure, it happens to me 4 or 5 times a day.
Wait, where'd she go? Did you see one of the performers rush by?
sir. I saw her bolt out of the door rather in a hurry. This is Dora Bailey with the Hollywood Buzz. Warner Brothers' first talkie turner, the jazz singer, is box office bofo. Meanwhile, Monumental Pictures announces a new Lockwood Lamont film, The Dueling Cavalier, swinging into theaters soon. I'm Dora Bailey, and that's the buzz.
Enter the star!
Cante, pure, di balletteri, better known as The Dueling Cavalier.
Why bother to shoot this picture? Why not just release the other one under a new title? I mean, if you've seen one, you've seen them all.
Why did you say that?
Say what?
That's what Kathy Selden said to me that night.
3 weeks ago and you're still thinking about it?
I can't get out of my mind.
Of course you can't. She's the first dame who hasn't fallen for your act since you were four.
He's on my conscience.
It isn't your fault she lost her job at the Coconut Grove.
Gotta find her.
Well, you've been trying to, haven't you?
All right, guys, put that stuff over there, get those lights wired, and set.
Come on now, Don, snap out of it! You can't let a little thing like this get you down. Well, you're Don Lockwood, aren't you? And Don Lockwood's an actor, isn't he? Well, what's the first thing an actor learns? Guys, what's
the show must go on.
An actor learns.
The show must go on.
Exactly. Come rain, come shine, come snow, come sleet. The show must go on. Though the world is so full of a number of things. I'm sure we should all be as happy as, but are we? No. Absolutely no. Definitely no. Decidedly no. Nuh-uh. Now remember, short people have long faces, and long people have short faces. Big people have little humor, and little people have no humor at all. Now, in the words of that immortal bard, Samuel Chase Snodgrass, as he was about to be led to the guillotine.
Make 'em laugh, make 'em laugh. Don't you know everyone wants to laugh? My dad said, be an actor, my son.
But be a comical one.
They'll be standing. For those old honky-tonk monkey shines.
Now you could study Shakespeare and be quite elite. And you could charm the critics in a method to eat. Just slip and up and net appeal the world's at your feet.
Make them laugh. Don't you know everyone wants to laugh?
My grandpa said go out and tell him a joke.
Make them roar, make them scream. Take a fall, bust a wall, split a seam.
Start by pretending you're a dancer with grace. You wiggle to their giggling all over the place. And then you get a great big custard pie in the face.
Make them laugh, make them laugh, make them laugh.
Make 'em laugh.
No, sir, director, sir. Nothing funny going on over here.
Hello, everyone. Hello.
Hello, Mr. Dexter.
Hello, Mr. Dexter.
Hello, Mr. Dexter.
Hello. What are we waiting for? Hey, where's Lina?
Miss Lina Lamont on the set, please.
Miss Lina Lamont on the set, please.
Miss Lina Lamont on the set, please. Here comes Miss Lina Lamont now.
You can
here comes.
I know, I know. Gee, this wig weighs a ton. But don't we wear a thing like this?
Everybody used to wear them, Lina.
And everybody was a dope.
Honey, you look beautiful.
Yes, you look great. So now let's get on to the set.
Devon, I looked for you the other night at Wally Ray's party. Where were you?
I've been busy.
And I know what you've been busy at, looking for that girl.
As a matter of fact, yes.
Why?
I've been worried about her.
You should have been worried about me, Lil. I'm the one who got whipped cream in my kisser.
But you didn't lose your job, and she did.
You're darn tootin' she did. I arranged it.
What?
They weren't gonna fire her. I called them up and told them they'd better.
Why? Why you?
Stop the chat, you lovebirds. Let's shoot the first scene. Quiet on set.
Quiet on the set.
Quiet on set.
Quiet on set.
Roll film.
Rolling.
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 Crossing, you lover, act with your eyes. Bigger eyes, you lover, let's see it.
Hold the Dexter, hold it.
Cut.
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 Tell him to go home. We're shutting down for a few weeks.
Shutting down?
The jazz singer, that's what's the matter. It's a sensation. The public is screaming for more.
More what?
Talking pictures, talking pictures.
Oh, that's just a freak.
We should have such a freak at this studio. Dexter, we've got to put our best foot forward, okay? We're going to make the Dueling Cavalier a talking picture.
But we don't know anything about talking pictures.
Don, believe me, it will be such a sensation. Lamont Lockwood, Lamont and Lockwood, they talk.
Well, of course we talk, doesn't everybody?
Lina, your talk might bring back the silent picture.
Warner Brothers, watch out. Monumental Pictures will soon be making musical movie motion picture history.
You heard him, everybody. Go home. We'll let you know when we're ready to start back up again. Perfect timing, Abby. I'd like you to meet Mr. Simpson.
How do you do?
I gather you're a very talented young lady.
Thank you.
Kathy, I'd like you to sing for Mr. Simpson now, if that's all right with you.
Sure, I'd love to.
Hey, Cosmo, can you play a quick audition?
I don't know a quick audition. Can you hum it for me?
Do you know You Are My Lucky Star?
And what key?
I saw you in the night.
Dawn, do you know this young lady?
That's Kathy Selden.
I'm thinking of casting her as the kid's sister in our next picture.
That's terrific!
Well, before Dawn refreshes your memory, you might as well know me as the girl who hit Miss Lamont in the face with the cake. Believe me, it was meant for Mr. Lockwood. I'm sorry, Dexter. I should have told you. Thanks anyway. Goodbye, Mr. Simpson.
Just a second, Mrs. Selden. RF?
Well, if it makes you unhappy when Lena's around, I mean...
Unhappy? I think it's wonderful.
He's been looking for her for weeks.
Are you speaking for Lena, too?
Now, look, RF. The owner of the Coconut Grove may do what Lena tells him to, but you're the head of this studio.
Yes, I'm the head of this studio. She's hired. Don't let Lena know that she's on the lot. Now it's all settled. Take care of it, Dexter.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Simpson.
Glad you turned up, Kathy. We've been searching in every cake in town.
Thanks, Cosmo.
Taxi.
Were you really looking for me?
I turned this town upside down. And then I got the New York office on it, and I remember that you said the New York stage was clamoring for you.
A slight exaggeration. I was clamoring for the New York stage. I started out for New York, then the talkies came.
You know, up to now, I haven't thought much of the talkies, but that's what brought you here, then it's the greatest invention since the wheel. Will you have lunch with me?
Sure, but... don't you usually share a pheasant at lunch with Miss Lamont?
Now look, Kathy, all that stuff about me and Lamont just sheer publicity.
Well, you do achieve a kind of intimacy in all your pictures, which would leave one to believe...
All of my pictures.
I guess, now that I think of it, I've seen 8 or 9 of them.
I still insist, if you've seen one, you've seen them all.
I did say some awful things that night, didn't I?
Of course, I deserved them. I mean, I must admit, I was pretty upset by them. So upset that I haven't been able to think anything but you since. Kathy, Kathy, I'm trying to say something to you, but... such a ham, I can't do it with the proper setting.
What do you mean?
Wait a second. Music?
A song until you came along. I played awake the whole night through, but if I dared to think you cared, this is what I'd say to you. You were meant for me, and I was meant for you. Nature patterned you when she was done. You were all the sweet things rolled up in one. You're like a plaintive that never lets me free, but I'm content the
toe two.
Ta-ta-ti-toe-two.
No, Miss Lamont. Round tones. Now let me hear you read your line.
I can't stand him.
I can't stand him.
I can't stand him.
Can't.
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 Can't. Can't.
Good. Now. Around the rocks, the rugged rascal ran.
Around the rocks,
Around the rocks, the rugged rascal ran. Now, sinful Caesar sipped his snifter.
Hiya, Cosmo.
Hello, dumb boys and girls.
Shall I continue?
Don't mind him.
Mr. Lockwood, repeat after me. Sinful Caesar sipped his snifter, seized his knees and sneezed.
Sinful Caesar snipped his snifter.
No. Sipped his snifter.
Sipped his snifter.
Oh, thank you. Sinful Caesar sipped his snifter. Seized his knees and sneezed.
Marvelous.
Do another one.
Everyone, repeat after me. Moses supposes his toes are roses, but Moses supposedly erroneously. Moses, he notices his toes aren't roses, as Moses supposes his toes to be.
Moses supposes his toes are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously.
But Moses, he noses his toes on the roses, but as Moses supposes his toes to be.
Moses supposes his toes are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously. A mose is a mose, a rose is a rose.
Toes is a toes.
Moses supposes his toes are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously.
Moses supposes his toes are roses.
His toes are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously. Dexter and all his assistants together can make Lina speak more euphoniously.
Lina, don't you remember I told you not to talk into the microphone? It's in the shrub.
But I told you, I can't do a love scene to a shrub!
Okay, we're gonna have to think of something else.
It looks like we're gonna be stuck here forever until Lina speaks for euphoniously.
Lina, look at the flower in your dress. The microphone is there, and all you have to do is talk into it, okay?
Okay.
Okay, quiet on set!
Quiet on set!
Quiet on set!
Lights, roll up!
Oh, Pierre, you shouldn't have come. You're flirting with danger. You...
What's that noise?
The mic's picking up her heartbeat.
Swell. That's just swell. Bye.
The diction is flipping the flickers, and gone is the silence that one used to be.
Will you knock it off? Jeez.
Okay, now Lina, the mic's on your shoulder, darling. And all you have to do is talk into the mic. That's it. Now don't make any sudden jerky movements or you might disconnect the mic, okay?
Okay.
Okay, quiet.
Quiet.
Quiet. Quiet.
Roll up.
Oh, Pierre, you shouldn't have come. You're flirting with danger.
What's this wire doing over here? It's dangerous.
Cut! Dang it! Cut!
This is Dora Bailey reporting live from outside a sneak preview of the newest Lockwood and Lamont picture. Let's hear what the crowd has to say.
Who cares if they can talk? That picture was awful. What a scream. Give me pictures like that jazz singer.
Someone get me to write the dialogue in that voice? Oh, Pierre, shouldn't come. I can't stand it.
We're ruined. We're all ruined.
We can't release this picture.
We've got to. We're booking. Six weeks. We're all over the country. But maybe we'll get by. Lockwood and Lamont are such big stars.
I never want to see that Lockwood and Lamont again.
Picture was awful.
This is the worst picture ever made.
I liked it.
Dawn, it wasn't that bad.
It's no use. There's no kidding myself either. Once they release the Dueling Cavalier, Lockwood and Lamont are through.
Well, things went wrong with the sound. Once you get the technical end straightened out.
No, it wasn't just that. Everything you said about me is true. No kidding. Cosmo, do you ever see anything as idiotic as me on that screen tonight?
Sure. What about Lina? I can't stand it!
Dawn, you're not through.
Why, of course not. Why, with your looks and figures, you could drive a ice wagon or shine shoes.
Block hats.
Sell pencils.
Dig ditches.
We're still go back to vaudeville. Fit as a fiddle, ready for love. I could jump over the moon up above. Fit as a fiddle and ready for love.
Too bad I didn't do that in the Dueling Cavalier. They might have liked it.
Well, why don't you?
What?
Make it a musical.
Sure. A musical picture. Oh, wait a second. Why don't we turn Dueling Cavalier into a musical?
That's impossible.
No, it isn't. You got 6 weeks.
Yeah. Just add some songs and dances. Trim the bad scenes and add some new ones.
And you're set.
Well, I guess, but do you really think that we can do it?
Of course we can.
It's a cinch.
You know what? You're right. The picture can be saved.
Hot dog!
Hallelujah!
Listen, if we can pull this off, this day will go down in history for me. March the 23rd!
Your historic day's not the 23rd. It's the 24th!
What do you mean the 24th?
It's 1:30 already! It's morning!
And what a lovely morning!
Good morning!
Good morning!
We've talked the whole night through. Good morning!
Good morning
to you!
Good morning.
It's great to say late.
Good morning.
Good morning to you.
When the band began to play, the stars were shining bright.
Now the milkman's on its way. It's too late to say goodnight.
So good morning.
Good morning.
And you.
Morning. Good morning. We got the whole night through. Good morning.
greater than being lived yet.
In the morning, it's great to stay up late. Good morning to
Might
you.
Might be Mississippi if we was in Mississippi.
When we left the movie show, the future wasn't bright. But came the time the show goes on, and I don't wanna say goodnight.
Well, say good morning.
Good morning, rainbow is shining through. Good morning.
Bonjour. Buenos dias.
Muchas frias.
Bonjour. Good morning.
Now the first thing that we have to do in the picture is, wait a second. What about Lina?
Lina. She can't sing, she can't act, she can't dance. A triple threat. Wait a second. I'm about to be absolutely incredible. Kathy, stand behind me, sing.
Huh?
Sing.
Good morning. We've talked the whole night through.
Well, convincing?
Enchanting, why?
Don't you get it? We use Kathy's voice and Lina.
That's wonderful.
No. I couldn't let you do that, Kathy.
Why not?
Well, because you wouldn't be seen. You'd be basically throwing away your own career.
It has nothing to do with my career. It's only for one picture. The important thing now is to save the dueling cavalier. Save Lockwood and Lamont.
Yeah.
Well, if it's only for this one picture, do you think it'll get by?
Of course it will.
Okay, well then we'll go to a riff and spring it to him in the morning.
Well, it's 3 o'clock already, almost my bedtime. I'd best be going.
I'll take you home.
Better take care of that throat. You're a big singing star now, remember? This California dew is a little heavier than usual this morning.
Really? Well, from where I'm standing, the sun is shining all over the place.
Good night.
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling, I'm happy again. I'm laughing at the clouds, so dark up above. The sun's in my heart, and I'm ready for love. Let the storm chase everyone from the place. Come on with the rain, I've got a smile on my face. I'll walk down the lane with a happy refrain, just singing in the rain.
Dancing in the rain. Da-da-da-da-da-da. I'm happy again. I walk down the lane with a happy thing. Thank you.
Can you play rollback for Would You? Now just watch her, Kathy.
Rolling.
And would you dare to say, let's do the same as they? I would
stop right there. All right, Kathy. Just a test. No vocals this time, Sam.
Ready.
Action.
And would you dare to say, let's do the same this way?
How's it look?
Great. It's gonna work. It's gonna work.
Sure.
Kathy, I can't wait till this picture is finished. Then, no more secrecy. I'm going to let Lina know. Let everyone know.
Your fans will be bitterly disappointed.
From now on, there's only one fan I'm disappointed. I'm worried about.
There!
Whoa!
What did I tell you, Lina?
Oh, Dawn! Zelda, thanks! You're a real pal!
Now, Lina.
I want that girl off the lawn at once! She's not gonna be my voice! Zelda here told me everything!
Thanks, Zelda. You're a real pal.
Anytime, Dawn.
Now, look, Miss Lamont, Dawn and I haven't...
Dawn? Dawn? You don't call him Dawn! I was calling him Dawn before you were born!
I happen to be in love with her.
That's ridiculous! Everyone knows you're in love with me!
Now, Lina, try and understand this. I'm going to marry her.
I'll put a stop to that. I'm going right up to CRF now.
You're a little too late, Lina. We're going to get this picture finished, and if this girl weren't in it, you'd be finished too.
As far as I can see, she's the only one who's finished. We'll never hear from her.
Everybody. Kathy nearly sold Beautiful Girl, and she's getting the second lead in her next movie.
She is.
And she's getting full screen credit for dubbing your voice.
What? You mean it's going to say on screen that I don't sing and talk myself?
Of course. What do you think?
You can't do that!
It's already done.
But nobody knows about it yet.
They will. There's a whole publicity campaign being planned.
They can't make a fool out of Lina Lamont! What do they think I am? Dumb or something? Why, I make more money than Calvin Coolidge put together.
Zelda, you know, you have to see things with your own eyes to believe it. If you hadn't opened my eyes, I'd still be walking around in the dark.
That's what friends are for.
You're a real pal. This business is a jungle. It's dog eat dog. Vultures out there waiting to eat your carcass before you're dead. And how about that little snake in the grass?
I told you.
You were right, and I wasn't gonna believe you. Can you imagine the lies she must have told him about me? Me, his fiance, the girl he's gonna marry. He read all about it.
Here, you must be broken-hearted.
Think of all those people when they find out they're using someone else's voice instead of mine. And what's wrong with my voice anyway?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Ain't it the truth?
Don't let it upset you, honey. You know how much it makes you sweat. And remember, last time you got hives.
I'm beautiful, ain't I?
For sure.
And I'm talented, ain't I?
For sure.
If you was a man, you could fall in love with me.
For sure.
And you would never be unfaithful. What's wrong with me? Why doesn't he kiss me? He has the chance for a romance. What's wrong with me? What's wrong with him? We should be out dancing. I want to try. He'd rather not. What's wrong with him? Things more important than diction. So what that a girl can't fix on? I said it. Why is he causing such friction? When he should be Mr. Lamont. What's wrong?
You sent me for me, boss?
Where's Don?
I think he's working with Kathy Selden.
So that's the problem Lena found out. Explains why Hurricane Lena just stormed through here.
Hey, Aura, have you seen the new footage of Woody?
That Selden girl is great no matter what Lena says. When the picture is released, I'm going to give her a big build-up. How much is there left to do?
We're still trying to crack that big production number, boss.
Tap dancing.
Huh?
We've got to have tap dancing.
Can't have tap dancing? The picture takes place in the French Revolution.
How's this? We've thrown a modern section into the picture. The star is a young Broadway hoofer, right?
Right.
He sings and dances, right?
Right.
So one night, he was reading A Tale of Two Cities. Between number C, a sandbag falls on his head, and voila! He dreams he's back in the French Revolution. Right?
Sensational!
Excuse me? Cosmo, but how are you going to do that?
Close your eyes. Close your eyes. And imagine this.
Don't bring a frown to old Broadway. You've got your frown on Broadway. Your troubles there.
Great.
Broadway rhythm, it's got me every dance. Out on the Greenway way, in the train, a grand display, taking your breath away with the Broadway rhythm, it's got me every sing and dance.
Now, boss, imagine that with John and Kathy. What do you think?
It's a little hard to imagine. Can you tell it to me again?
Hello out there. This is Dora Bailey talking to you at the premiere of the monumental pictures, The Dancing Cavalier. Once again, we reunite those immortal screen lovers, Don Lockwood and Lina Lamont, in our first all talking, all singing, all dancing musical romance. It is an event that will go down in cinema history.
You're terrific. Lockwood and Lamont are gonna be greater than ever. It was good, wasn't it?
Wonderful, Dawn. It worked. The public loves you two.
You're dying too, and they do.
And Kathy, we owe you a lot.
Thanks.
Lina, you were fabulous. You sing as well as Kathy Selden.
Yeah, and I'm going to for a long time.
Hey, what do you mean?
I mean she's going to keep right on doubling for me.
Listen, Lina, we only did this just to save one picture.
That's what you think.
Listen, you boa constrictor, don't get any fancy ideas about the future. Tell her, RF.
Never mind, RF. Listen to that applause. There, it's for me, Lina Lamont. Wait until the money starts rolling in.
She's got something there. It's a gold mine. We got no quartz.
Miss Lamont?
You got a 5-year contract, honey.
Just a minute, Lina.
This is Lena's big night, and she is entitled to do the talking, right?
You're darn right. Right. Ladies and gentlemen, I can't tell you how thrilled we are at your reception of The Dancing Cavalier, our first musical picture together. If we bring a little joy into your humdrum lives, it makes us feel as if all our hard work hasn't been in vain for nothing. Bless you all.
Hey, you do didn't sound that way in the picture.
Cut the talk, Lena. Sing. Sing
us. Yeah, Lena.
Sing! Wait a second. Cosmo, RF, I've got an idea.
What am I gonna do? Tell him I got a cold, a frog, or something!
Lena, we've got it. Roz, get a microphone and set up the back of the curtain. Kathy will stand back there and sing for you.
Dawn!
You've got to do it, Kathy.
You mean she'll be back of the curtain, singing, and I'll be out front, making with the mouth, like in the picture?
Do it.
She's got to do it!
Of course she's got to do it. She's got a 5-year contract with me. Get her over there to the microphone, Miss Selden.
You heard him. Kathy, do it.
All right, I'll do it, Dawn. But I'll never see you again, on or off the screen.
Well, at last someone's getting some sense around here. Thank you, Donnie.
Miss Lamont, what are you going to sing? Would you? Miss Lamont, what key?
E.
C.
He holds her in her arms. Would you? He tells her of her charms. Would you?
And would you dare to say, let's do the same as they?
Kathy, ladies and gentlemen, stop that girl. That girl running up the aisle. Stop her. That's the girl whose voice you heard and loved tonight. She's the real star of the picture, Kathy Selden.
You are my lucky star. I saw you from afar.
Two lovely eyes at me, they were gleaming.
Gleaming. I was a star. You're all my lucky charm.
I'm lucky in your eyes. You've
dark up above. I'm singing,
singing in the rain
under my umbrella. Ella, Ella, eh, eh, eh. Under my umbrella. Ella, eh, 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 eh.
These fancy things will never come in between. You're a part of my entity, here for infinity. When the world has took its part, when the world has dealt its cards, if the hand is hard, together we'll mend your heart. Cause I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain.
You can hear, feel it, I'm happy as hell. I'm laughing out loud. So don't you go for boy. I'm singing, singing in the rain.
You can stand under my umbrella. Ella, Ella, Ella.
Just singing in the rain. Feeling I'm happy again. I'm laughing at clouds so dark up above. I'm singing, singing in the rain.
It's raining, raining. Ooh, baby, it's raining, raining. Baby, come hear me. Come hear me. It's raining, raining. Ooh, baby, it's raining.
All right, everyone. Great job. Time for bows. Give yourselves a round of applause. Give yourself, give your neighbor a high five. Give your cast members a high five. Time for some bows. Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in and watching.